Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Biometric technology has become a pretty interesting and fascinating subject, I would say, within the last couple of years. It really took off, I would say, once Apple had released Touch ID with their iPhone. Since then, a lot of people have been very much fascinated by biometrics. It appears that it's going to be the next billion-dollar industry as well, a very fast-growing industry. To speak with us on this subject is Rawlson King. He is the contributing editor and lead researcher at biometricupdate.com. Rawlson, thank you for coming on the show.
Oh, absolutely. No problem.
So, Rawlson, I wanted to ask you, what are some of the most fascinating developments that you're seeing take place currently with biometric technology?
I think what you just pointed out, which is the emergence of biometrics in the consumer marketplace. Typically, biometrics has been conceived of as a set of technologies that have really been beneficial primarily to governments and to large enterprises in terms of their security requirements. And I think what you're now seeing is the emergence of a consumer marketplace, which is also driven by security to basically enable protection of transactions, protection of commerce, but also we're seeing the integration of biometric technologies into wearable devices, which is tremendously interesting. And obviously, once you start tapping into the consumer electronics marketplace, you're talking about a multi-billion dollar marketplace. A biometric research group, which is the parent company of Biometric Update that undertakes market research, has projected that global biometrics, that the entire marketplace will grow to $15 billion by next year, by 2015, from its estimated 2012 value of $7 billion. Past 2015, we expect a more exponential rate of growth because the technology is now moving into the consumer space. Those numbers that we had projected previously were really predicated on the idea of biometrics being primarily a security technology used by governments and enterprise. We agree with you. It'll be absolutely interesting to see biometrics move into the consumer space, and in particular, the mobile commerce space.
Let's talk about some of the companies and some of the technologies that are coming out right now. You know, I'm just looking at your site right now, biometricupdate.com, and I know you have pretty much like a daily blog where you show a lot of the different developments and things that are taking place. I'd come across one really interesting product that is pretty fascinating, and that's by a company called BioNim, and they have what's called the NIMI, which is a bracelet that goes around your wrist and it measures your heartbeat in real time. Do you mind describing some of these things that are going on?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.